Thank you for joining CACE International. I'm Fakisha Kumbo, and we have a very special show. We have trombonist virtuoso Mr. Slide Hampton. But first, we're going to show you him in performance at the Boat Basin here in New York City. And then we're going to come back and find all about his illustrious career.
Thank you.
Slide, thank you so much for joining us today on CACE INT'L.
I'm very happy to be here with you.
Tell me, how'd you get the name Slide?
Well, I was born into a musical family. My sisters and brothers, my father and mother were all musicians. I was the youngest one, the last one of the family. At that time, they had no trombone players in the family. They said, you're going to play trombone, and you're going to be called Slide Hampton. And that's how it happened.
So how old were you then?
I actually started playing at the age of 12, but I was participating in the family entertainment before that as a dancer and singer.
So when did you turn professional?
Well, I don't know if I turned professional yet.
When did you start getting paid for it?
Well, I did. The first band that I actually played with that brought me to New York City with Buddy Johnson. The band, Buddy Johnson, Ella Johnson, Arthur Blackstock, and all those people. And I actually came with that band to New York to live in New York. So that was in the early 50s.
Uh-huh. So were you around in the bebop era?
Oh, yes, very much.
Tell us about it.
Well, we were actually raised in Indianapolis, and my brothers and I, who were very much influenced by Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie and J.J. Johnson. We were collecting all of the records when the bebop era began, actually.
Uh-huh.
And we were there when it did start, but when I came to New York, then it was kind of the end of the bebop era, but it was still happening and it was still very influential.
Did you get a chance to play on 52nd Street and 6th Avenue?
I not only played there, I lived there.
I
used to live right across the street from Birdland. I used to go over there, and when I was working, I worked over there with Maynard Ferguson and Art Blakey, and I went over there many times to hear the John Coltrane group and Miles Davis and all of those guys.
What was it like working with Buena, Art Blakey?
It was wonderful. He was one of the most natural musicians ever existing in music, and he was a guy that really gave all of the young musicians a chance to learn in his band. It was like a school being with Buena.
Well, you know, you seem to be doing somewhat of the same. You have a group called Jazz Masters.
Right.
And tell us about the multi-generational gap in that band.
Well, actually, the purpose of that group is to give the young musicians and the old musicians a chance to work together like it was in the 40s and 50s. That's how we learned. We were having an opportunity when we were younger to work with the older musicians, and they were teaching us. They were very helpful, and we're creating that same kind of situation in the Jazz Masters Ensemble.
Who do you have in that ensemble? Because we're going to play some music from that.
Well, there's a lot of great musicians there. We can start at the older guys, Jimmy Heath, for instance.
Oh, yeah.
He's not really old, but he's older than some of the guys in the ensemble. But he's one of the guys that influences all of us, and I actually have gotten a lot of my experience with Jimmy Heath also. And there's George Mraz on bass, and I guess I'm one of the senior citizens of the group myself. And then we start getting into the next generation of guys. John Faddis was on the record.
Oh, he's a Dizzy Gillespie protege.
He's a very powerful musician, and it's been a big help, and we've really enjoyed working together very much. And then we have Roy Hargrove also as one of the trumpeters, and David Sanchez.
These are the young guys.
But it is wonderful for us to have the opportunity to work with them, because a lot of the things that we've experienced we do impart to them, and they bring a lot of enthusiasm and inspiration to us.
How did the Jazz Masters come into being?
Well, actually, 3 years ago there was a group that was put together called the Dizzy Gillespie's United Nation Orchestra. That was put together by Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Fishman. I was in that ensemble, and some of the people that are in the Jazz Masters also was in that ensemble. That group was made up of musicians of all the different countries, Cuba, South America, America, of course, and Puerto Rico. We were playing music mainly based on Latin rhythms.
Hmm.
We played with that ensemble and recorded for 2 years. And then we decided that we wanted to play some more. We were still playing the Dizzy Gillespie repertoire, so we wanted to play some music mainly based on the straight ahead concept. So we decided to put this group together called the Jazz Masters, and it came actually out of that group of the United Nations Orchestra.
Now, when you say, for our audience, when you say straight ahead, what are you talking about?
Well, okay. You know, as you know, the Latin rhythm, which has influenced Dizzy's music a lot and influenced all the American music, is a rhythm that has a lot of syncopation, very strong syncopation in it. Now, what happened when people came along like Sid Catlett and Kenny Clarke and people like that, they started to play a rhythm that was more constant, more straight, without so many strong syncopated beats. that's what we call straight ahead. The rhythm that depends on mainly on the what we call the trap drums, playing a straight rhythm that doesn't have so many strong beats in it. It's very strong, but not in the way that you would think of in the Latin music.
So is it something like, would you call bebop straight ahead?
Well, bebop was based on the straight ahead concept, but it had a lot of strong accents in it too. That's one of the things that made it interesting.
So this is a whole lesson to learn behind that alone.
It's a great deal to learn about it.
Why do they call jazz, quote unquote, America's classical music?
Well, like any classical music, you see, classical music usually comes from the folk music of any country. And with musicians that are usually very dedicated, they usually develop that folk music to the highest level possible, which usually after requires musicians of the virtuoso level to play it. And that's the reason this music is called classical, because it was developed by people like Louis Armstrong and Lester Young and Dizzy Gillespie to the level of what we would call virtuosity.
Tell me something about Diz in this couple of minutes before we have to go to Case Gallery.
Well, he was one of the most dedicated musicians of all of the musicians, and I constantly tell people when I think of Dizzy now, wherever he is, I think of him somewhere sitting at a piano, learning things and teaching things to people that are around him.
Because he was really a pianist as well, wasn't he?
Well, all the great musicians played piano. You know, it was the way that you had to in order to learn the compositions and learn the repertoire. You have to play piano. Miles played, Dizzy played, all of them played.
Do you play?
Yes, I love the piano.
Yeah? I mean, could you really sit and play play?
I could play something for you now if we had a piano.
Oh, yes. Wow, sorry we don't have a piano. Are the jazz masters going to stay together?
Yes, they definitely are. We'll be doing many of the festivals next year in Europe and also in America.
Uh-huh.
And we're going in a couple of weeks to France to do a couple of concerts there now. And we'll be working also in December in America with the Jazz Masters. So we're going to stay together, yes.
Oh, so we can look forward to hearing you somewhere in the New York City area, can't we?
You certainly can.
All right. That's great. All right, we're going to take a break here and listen to some of the music of the Jazz Masters. We're going to play Night in Tunisia. Because this whole album was kind of dedicated to Diz, wasn't it?
Yes, we actually did dedicate this to Diz because we actually expected him to be a part of this ensemble.
Yeah.
And I still feel he's certainly here, but we hope that he'd be here with us now. So in spirit he is.
He's
and in
here.
This music you can see.
When you hear this music, Night in Tunisia, we're going to play this tune and we're going to look at the work of David Da Silva, who's a fantastic photographer. He's a Latino brother who has exhibited here in New York as well as around the country. So let's take a look at some of David Da Silva's work and listen to Mr. Slide Hampton and his group playing Night in Tunisia from Dizzy Gillespie's repertoire. All right.